you crazy? What the hell are you talking about? He wouldn't come within 100 miles of you.
Yes, that's right. That's why I wanted your advice.
Barbara, I've already told you. I'm having nothing more to do with you.
Oh, well, it would be wonderful if you could come in tomorrow, Philip, and I'll be glad to have you there when I speak to him.
All right. What are you after?
Good. Tomorrow morning's perfect, then. I'll be interested to hear what George has to say.
Forget it. I'm not coming in, with or without George Logan.
Well, don't forget about that money that I gave you.
What about it?
That's a good point. I don't think the police know about that, do they?
You blackmailing little bitch!
Good. I'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow morning, then. Bye, Philip. Thank you.
Everything okay?
Everything's fine. Philip's going to bring George in tomorrow. I thought he would.
Representing Miss Daniels.
Oh, excuse me, Your Honor. It was going to be Mr. Horton, but he had to... He left.
You have no one acting for you, yet you've pleaded not guilty to the charges.
That's right, Your Honor. But I don't mind giving it a bill myself.
Do you mean you wish to conduct your own defense?
Yeah. May as well, eh?
No, Maxine.
Silence. Who are you?
Judy Bryant. I run the halfway house.
What is your relationship to the accused?
Well, we're just friends.
If you are not her defense counsel, you have no business trying to speak to her.
No, Your Honor.
Excuse me, Your Honor, but Judy runs the halfway house where I live, and it was her that made me see that I ought to be out and about trying to help others.
Am I to understand that this person will be testifying in your defense?
Yeah. Oh, no. Well, I don't know.
Miss Daniels, as you're obviously ill-prepared to conduct your own defense, I'm postponing your case till you can present it in a civil and correct manner. I suggest that you use the interim period in finding a member of the legal profession to present it for you. This case is adjourned until the 25th.
Your Honor, is there any chance of bail?
Oh, Jude, I can't. I got no dough.
Well, couldn't she get out on her own recognizance?
Yeah! What's that mean, Jude?
When you have finished your conversation, it means, Miss Daniel, that we take your word that you'll show up for your hearing. But judging from your past record and what I've seen today, I will not grant such bail.
Well, what if I go surety for her?
Bail set at a surety of $300. Next case.
Beauty!
Trouble and preferably out of sight for a week. If I could tie you down, I would.
Oh, fair go, Jude. I reckon I could have handled my own defense anyway.
Yeah, and do you think that you would have handled another 5 years in Wentworth? Because that's exactly what you would have got. It was the most stupid, harebrained idea I ever heard of.
I would have only been telling the truth. I stole the stuff for charity.
Maxine, let your lawyer handle everything. All you got to do is front up on the 25th for Mr. Horton. I got to go to Sydney, but if I come back and find out that you've shot through, you're going to wish you were in jail.
Oh, no worries, Jude. I never let a mate down.
Got something for me, Lawson?
To creep up on people like that?
I do what I like in here, Lawson. You should know that by now.
Yeah, well, that's the trouble with some people. Give them a uniform and they think they're God.
Oh, that's a nasty little comment. Getting quite cocky with your new tough image, aren't you? You better be careful. Saying things like that could land you in solitary.
Oh, all right. I'm sorry. Didn't mean anything by it. I just got a fright when you jumped out on me, that's all.
Of course, I wasn't referring to myself, but, there are some officers who could trump up a whole string of charges against you. Keep you locked in that tiny little cell on your own for ages and ages. But I'm really quite nice to prisoners who do things for me.
What do you want?
I seem to recall you promised to stir B. Smith up.
Well, I've tried. I've been getting the women to bet every 5 minutes and rubbing B's nose in it. She just won't bite.
Then you'll just have to try harder.
Well, what can I do? I've got to share a cell with her at night.
Oh, yeah, that's true. I've also heard that that's one of her favourite tricks, too. Waiting till her victims are asleep. Tell you what, you get Smith to jump you when I'm around and I'll see you transferred to another cell.
Yeah, I'll bet. Solitary.
Ah, Smith will be in there for attacking you.
What about the other screws?
Oh, I can keep them off your back. But of course, if you decide not to help me, then I'll have to start trumping up those charges. Now, let's see, running an illegal book could get you, at least a week.
Hello, that looks ominous. Don't tell me we're playing musical cells again.
No, I just had a call from the gate. We've got a new customer. I'm trying to work out where I can put her.
Is she a first-timer?
Not according to a file. She's paid a couple of visits to Mullewa in the past, mainly prostitution.
Mm-hmm.
Latham's on her own.
Well, that's a good choice. They should get on well together. well as Latham can get on with anyone.
Ah, Seymour. Thanks. Stand on that white line, will you? Your name is Penny Kathleen Seymour, is that correct?
Yes.
You are charged with soliciting for the purposes of prostitution and sentenced to 7 days imprisonment, is that correct?
Yes.
You will go to the bench. You'll place all your personal belongings, jewellery and cash on it.
I know what's there, so don't try anything.
One more crack like that, and the next 7 days could be the slowest in your life. Go in there and take a shower. Then Mrs. Morris will take you through for a medical.
Only 12 months on the game. She has had a busy year. Ah, Sister Mary must be in the hospital. Sit down here, will you? There's a new arrival for examination. I'll put a file on the table.
G'day. I'm Neil Murray.
I thought you said Sister Murray.
Unfortunately, that's what you get for entering a predominantly female profession. But you can call me Mr. Murray.
Fair enough. I just wasn't expecting to see a bloke.
Yes, well, there's no need to be embarrassed. I've been studying nursing for years, and I've seen it all before.
That's all right. I've shown it all before.
Really? Penny Seymour?
That's right.
Well, this is just a standard examination, Penny, to determine that you're clean and healthy and not bringing anything contagious into the prison.
Yeah, I know. I've had one before.
Yes, I see.
It's a nuisance, though. It means you have to work twice as hard when you get out to make up for the money you lose.
Yes, well, just under the top of your blouse, will you?
Of course, there's always the chance of making a bit inside. You can get discount rates if you liked.
Breathe in.
The male screws will probably be in it, but it's a bit difficult when they're not supposed to be alone with you. But you've got a nice little setup here. Getting to see your patients on their own?
I said breathe in. Out.
Well, let me know if you change your mind.
I've got to check your head for lice, huh?
Gee, you really know how to make a girl feel attractive.
Well, you stupid bitch, what the hell are you doing?
Oh, sorry, it was an accident.
Oh, yes, like hell. What do you want detergent for anyway?
They're running out.
Well, if they want it, they can get it for themselves. You stick to your job and let them stick to theirs.
Don't tell me what to do, you fat bitch.
Oh! Oh!
Oh!
go, Smith. Break it up. You'll be on a charge for this.
Oh, what a crap. She attacked me.
Get moving, Smith. Off to the pound. Just